Brandon Oliver.
Okay, you heard it right here. July 8th, Impacto Promotions will be doing another show right here in this building at the Marion County Fairgrounds.
Yeah.
Don't miss this action, guys. I'm telling you, if you're local, come out, check it out. If you're not local, get the pay-per-view. It's as simple as that. You can sit home, eat pizza, chicken wings, drink beer, hang out with your girl,
and do what you want to do, blow
play with your
blow
dog,
with a Ronin.
Sing to your bird. I don't care what you do, just get the pay-per-view and check us out. Because if you know Bad Ronin's in the house, you know we're going to have a damn good time.
Exactly.
And
right.
If Kiko Suarez is here with me, hey, it's lit.
All right, so here we have a very good
The guy over here looks like the five-finger death punch.
Yeah, this is the Two Brothers Muay Thai gym from Louisville. And this is a very serious gym, very serious Muay Thai style gym. Glad that the Two Brothers gym is here. You will see some of the good technique that this gym instills in their fighters. Very serious group of people, giving exposure to these fighters in this kind of local show.
I like what I'm seeing so far, man. Let's see how this goes.
Let's see how it goes. He doesn't have a lot of experience. He has two losses.
He's now making his way to the red corner, Nick Fisher.
That's Oliver, yeah.
All right, so Nick has an interesting both last name and nickname. Because his last name is Butcher.
Body Bag Butcher. The other one's Crawdad. I mean, it don't get no... Man, come on. Now that I'm remembering, I watched the Crawdad last time.
Possibly.
I seen him. Yeah, I seen this before. It might be time to eat. You ever seen a Crawdad eat?
Right, yeah.
Kind of creepy, bro.
Well, it looks like Nick is also coming up with also not a lot of experience, 1-0, but he comes very concentrated. I can see him now getting in the ring. In the red corner.
Looks like we're poised for an interesting fight here.
Yes, and same height, 5'11".
Scheduled for 3 2-minute rounds in the 155-pound weight division. Your referee, Tiger Banks. Fighting out of the blue corner, representing Two Brothers Muay Thai.
Two Brothers.
52.5 pounds, with a record of 1 win and 2 losses. From Louisville, Kentucky, Brandon Crawdad Oliver!
The Crawdad's in the house!
I don't
know if this place is big enough for Bad Ronin and the Crawdad, too. Man, we got some characters in here tonight. This is fun, though. Watch this.
Body Bag Butcher!
The Body Bag! Woo!
Now let's see.
Yeah, I had him on Iron Kickboxing as well. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
I'm excited for this fight. I hope that they can put a good kind of kickboxing style.
Go.
Nice.
Something about the Crawdad last time. I'm trying to remember. I think he was very methodical about the way he handled the fight, and
he's gonna probably try to clinch. We have to just, the beginning of these rounds is always telling, because I can see that the blue corner is poised. The red corner is a little excited. If he can capitalize on that excitement, then maybe he's going to do some damage.
Right.
But you will see how possibly the blue corner will start chipping away a little bit. Is now when that all that initial energy is gone, and now you have to start just finding the distance, using the weapons.
If I remember, he came on slow in the last fight I saw him with Crawdaddy. He came on slow, kind of going with that
right.
that theme. He has the moniker, I guess, for a reason. And Crawdads aren't super fast.
Right.
Now they can get away, but they're not super fast.
He, I'm starting to see that he can use that lead kick both down and middle section.
A couple nice kicks to the body from the red side.
Yeah.
And he's keeping moving. That's important.
Yeah.
You know, don't stand
there
still.
There you go. So now that clinch, if it happens, but he didn't.
I almost thought the Crawdad was letting him get some of it off and maybe try to fatigue him a little bit in that first round and see how he comes out in the second round.
Possibly, because he's missing a lot now.
He's missing a lot, exactly. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Maybe
so,
burn himself up a little bit.
Yeah. The beauty of coming out with energy is if you hit and you make an impact. But if you don't, then you're tired and the other one already knows your distance. I think we're going to see picking up the pace now, probably from the blue corner.
I think he wanted to see what he was going to do in that first round. You know, now he could anticipate the second round a little different. Let's see what kind of strategy the corners employing now after that first round.
I think so too.
Red corner just needs to keep his hands and feet moving. Don't stand still. Okay, we ready.
There we go, round second two. Round.
Butcher came forward.
I see that.
He forced him to strike
yeah,
back.
Yeah, now that's losing energy with those. Those are your favorite ones. So, let's see if they can just get in with some good kicks that make some damage.
Brought a high kick there.
Yeah. And I had to just start bringing it.
Yeah, caught with the short right hand there.
There you go. So
Butcher,
that was
Butcher
a good.
Threw us a little stab to the belly. A little change level jab to the belly. I always like that.
There you go. So that's a nice middle
left
kick,
body.
And he has.
There's a sweep.
He has a yes. He has a very good reflex and catching. So catching
that's
kicks
clean.
Is very important. It's a
you
very
can
important
do that.
Skill.
And like I said, that changes the energy.
Yes.
So see if that has any effect. He came right back up.
We're gonna have later Carson, and Carson has always been masterful at catching kicks. So.
Ooh, he caught him with an uppercut, stood him up, left hand, he turned.
Yes.
He's got to keep his hands up.
Yes.
Got to keep his hands up. He's going to catch another slow, methodical.
Yes. And
building.
And I would say.
Tempo building.
The blue fighter needs to now take this opportunity, maybe start mixing some kicks down or like that, those knees, and then start. There you go. So now he can go with the boxing.
That uppercut stood him up straight, and he caught him with that left
knee in the corner.
That. He's got to watch turning. You got to watch the turn. You're going to catch that kick high. That's gonna
happen. Don't look away.
Stay by the bell on that one. He's got this round.
And he's got, but yeah. And
see, you cannot turn. You cannot cannot turn, you cannot cower, you cannot turn your back.
That's a horrible.
As soon as you turn, you're looking at that high kick coming to your face. It's almost instant.
Terrible behavior that needs to change right
away. And it's
away.
Great technique to use against an adversary that turns their back to you.
Yeah.
Come with that high kick straight to the face. You see him building through there, building through, you know. It was motorcycle again, first gear the whole first round. He just went second gear into third gear. Now he's gonna go in here.
Yeah. Now, I'm pretty sure
I want to say he might finish this up.
Yeah.
We'll see. Seconds out.
They now they have to manage the energy they have left and see how they go in this 2 minutes.
Third and final round. Make some noise if you know my
man. All right, here they go.
Here we go. Start of the third round.
That is I think
straight
that,
to the center.
He's a little
put him to the corner already.
Yes.
They're just wailing it out over there now.
It's his corner. His coaches are right there. So
what? Crawdad's corner told him to come out and turn it up.
Yeah, see that?
There it is.
Catching,
down again.
Catching kicks and sweeping is critical.
I'm telling you, that definitely has an effect on you. You get slammed down on the ground a couple times.
It does.
And no now, different than a shot in a double shot, double leg takedown right. Slam, you know?
But you see, now
you're hard on your back.
Now you're going to start to see the techniques and the.
Right here.
There you go. So that those are the.
Like
knees.
I said,
that's
when I say
it.
Best seat in the house, I literally mean the best seat in the house.
So now I think that.
Settle for nothing less, Kiko.
Correct. There you go.
You deserve the best, my friend.
Those low kicks as an approaching technique. And now he has him in the corner.
He's dazed a little bit too over that.
Yeah. So I would just.
That definitely had an effect.
Go with those low kicks again and just get him in the corner. And now he has the knees. So he has to clinch and get those knees up. Clinch and get those. There you go. Now he's going just castigating that. That's it.
Driving them knees in. That's driving it. Them knees
and
in.
Now,
right hand.
Now is the boxing.
Side effects.
Now is when the boxing right takes care of things.
He's standing straight up. He's got to bring his hands up.
Yeah. Now.
Got to bring his elbows in. Bring them hands up.
Those. One of the key things for the red corner right now is to try to pivot out of those positions. He needs to pivot out.
I keep seeing him turn and
he
like he
pivot
wants to
there.
Dart away, but he turns his head. You can't turn your head and do that.
And
you have to keep your hands up and move your whole torso.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
I agree.
Keep your
This was a good fight. Obviously, for me, it was the blue corner who won. Better technique, better management of the fight.
Interesting fight, but like I was talking about, the Crawdad has that slow, methodical development.
Yes.
And I think it went exactly the same way the last time. So what I would say is if you're fighting the Crawdad, you better get out here and get your stuff off in that first round and try to take advantage of that excitement that you were talking about.
Right.
Because if you let it go into the laters, you let it go into the later rounds, you might end up getting drowned.
Yeah.
And eaten.
Exactly. They need to take advantage of it. I think the Crawdad likes you.
Any many decisions with precision I pick or make my selection on who I choose. Girl, don't touch
they did
my
an excellent job.
You want it to slip, but
can you hear me okay now?
No. Tip it for life. That's like making it rain every month on schedule.
Let me tell you, you have to probably keep changing.
It's gonna get better. Prepare your brother, see some hope. She's supposed to spend it.
Ladies and gentlemen, first two judges score this about the same. 27-29. Judge number three scores the bout 29-28. All for your winner by unanimous decision, Brandon Crawdad Oliver!
All right, nice work, guys.
Okay, let's see if you can hear me, Mike. Probably not. Not much.
All right.